Hey guys, what's up, Aziz here, coming at you with another Tips with Aziz in College Football 25. Did you know that you can practice your field goals in practice mode in College Football 25? I figured a lot of people might not have known this, and I definitely wanted to put that on the radar for everybody because I know how difficult it is to kick field goals, but it's not as difficult if you get some practice in, just like anything else. The more repetitions, the easier it gets. But before we get into this video, if you can please leave a like, and if you're new to the channel, subscribe, and be on the lookout for more Tips with Teeds in College Football 25. All you're gonna need to do is either go on offense only or normal mode in normal practice mode, and you have the option to kick a field goal or even practice your punting. For here, I'll just be practicing my field goal kicking, and what I recommend practicing as well as what I do when I do kick field goals. So you just go to special, RB or R1 on PlayStation, over to field goal, and then whichever one it is for field goal. I believe it's always going to be X for Xbox and square for PlayStation. If you're in a dynasty, whether it's online or offline, one thing I always recommend is getting a few practice kicks in with your kicker, because these are very, very different depending on your kicker. Depending on how much accuracy they have depends on how much you need to move the arrow left or right. Sounds very, very simple. This looks like a very easy kick, but for whatever reason, these kicks up close are much more difficult than they should be, but I definitely understand why they are difficult, because the angle of the kick itself is very, very difficult for even the best of kickers. So I always recommend practicing field goals from your hash on the right side, and then from your hash on the left side up close, and then moving back about as far as you can to see just how far your kicker can go. And if you haven't noticed already, we're going with Trujillo, who is the best kicker in College Football 25. He has a 99 leg, and take a look at this video that somehow I was able to knock this field goal through. 67-yard field goal, and I know there's 2 miles an hour wind to the left, but still, it went through, and I know it was red. Probably one of the farther kicks that you can do in the game. But back to this. What I look for when I'm kicking my field goals is, depending on how fast the ball is moving left and right, I will practice in my head. Once it hits the red on the right side, the football hits the red, I practice pressing A in my head where I would press it, and that would give me a good idea of where to hit it and when to press A. Obviously, you want to get that football in the middle of the green, and that helps it here. So with him being really accurate, I really don't have to go too far over here. Even if I miss it to the right a little bit, it goes in no problem at all. Some kickers, you really have to move it to the left, and with him, you really don't, so it doesn't really matter. But obviously, with your kicker, the more practice you get, the more confident you will get with kicking. This was the one thing that I did when I started with my online dynasty, because a lot of people were struggling with it, and we stream all of our games, so everyone's able to watch everyone and basically struggle with kicking. I went to the game practice mode, and I was like, yeah, that's not happening with me. I'm going to make sure I know how to kick my field goals. I'm going to see what the distance is and how difficult it is to kick up close. And fortunately, with this, I was able to find out that it's not as difficult as you think if you get practice in. It's very simple. Who would have thought? So I just need one more quick kick here. Look, not even a good kick there, but because he's a 90 accuracy, it doesn't really matter too much. But again, what I do is right hash up front, left hash up front, and I'm going to move the ball right now and respot ball to left hash right here. And these ones, I feel like the harder ones are going to be to the left side or the opposite side of the foot of your kicker. And for this guy, it should not be a problem draining this one right here, which we do. And now I'll move the ball backwards. I'll probably put it like the 40-yard line just to show you that it is possible to make long field goals. All right, so here we are on the 40-yard line. Obviously, the ball is moving like crazy, and it's not as difficult to think as long as you time it up in your head. If you ever remember playing that game at, whether you went to John's Incredible Pizza, you went to Chuck E. Cheese, whatever little gaming center you guys had, Captain Kids, whatever they were, they had that one light game where you would try to time up the light to your little light, and it would be spinning all the way around this little game, 360, all the way around, and there'd be like four different options for you to stop the light. And if you stopped it right on the middle of where your button was, well, then you got all the tickets. And so you would time it, right? You would practice timing that on the side. You wouldn't hit the actual buzzer, but you would practice timing it a few times to try to get that timing down. Essentially, that is what I am doing here, and I'm hoping I'm not outdating myself here by telling you the things that we would do back in the day as a 90s kid, but here we are. I wait for the ball to hit that red on the far right, and then I time it in my head where I would have to press to hit the football in the green. And let me do it quickly in my head and let me see if I could drain this. Again, another tip I would recommend before I do that is always aim your kicks down. Always aim them down. Always. You're not going to get blocked over the middle, so there's nothing to worry about making your kick a low driving kick. Now, back to hopefully me being able to time this. Okay, not bad at all. And with that leg, he drained it. That was a 57-yard field goal, and he didn't even fill up the bar. Look at that, right down the middle, green. It's very easy. Once you get the hang of it, it's not as difficult as you think. Obviously, the farther it is, the harder, but it's not as difficult once you get the timing down. Oh, filled the bar there. And look at this, a 57-yard. He absolutely drained it. I'm going to move it back a little bit. Here we are at the 47-yard line. It's going a bit faster, so that's 57, 64-yard field goal. A two-mounter went slightly in our face. Let's see if I'm able to drain this. Wow. Having a 99 power and 90 accuracy kicker really makes things a lot easier, I will say. But again, if you just time this out, it's not that difficult. So give yourself 2 to 3 minutes in this practice mode just to practice your kicks, and you'll have so much confidence, and it'll make the game so much easier. And honestly, you'll probably have an upper leg on your opponent. But that'll do it for this video, guys. If you guys did enjoy it, please leave a like. And if you're new to the channel, definitely subscribe and be on the lookout for more tips with Teeds and College Football 25. I'm out. Peace.